If you want to move your YouTube channel to another Google account, then you're in the right place. In this video, I'll help you navigate through this process whether you're using a Google account or a brand account with ease. Let's dive in. Here I am on YouTube. To get started, click on your channel icon in the top right-hand corner, and then make doubly sure you're on the correct account first. If you are, go back to that main menu and then click on YouTube Studio. Next, click on Settings in the bottom left-hand corner, then click on Permissions. Now look very carefully at this pane. So if it looks like this, you're in a Google account. That means it's going to take a few extra steps to move the account, so keep watching. If your permissions pane looks like this, specifically with this sentence right here, then you're in a brand account, so skip to the next chapter. If your permissions pane looks like this, where you have two separate buttons, skip to the chapter after next. Now, if you're still with me, that means your permissions pane looks like this and you're in a Google account. So let's click on Close and then back on your channel icon in the top right. Click on Your Channel, then click on your channel icon again, and this time click on Settings. You need to add a brand account. So on this page, click on Add or Manage Your Channel and then click on Create a Channel. You're about to create a brand account. Notice the fine print here on your channel name will be linked to a brand account. Name your channel however you like, then update your handle. Once you're ready, click Create Channel. You might get this message after you create the channel. Don't worry about it, everything's fine. Next, click on your channel icon again. You should be in the brand account now. Go ahead and switch your account back to the Google account. Then return to your settings by clicking on the channel icon and clicking settings. Now that you've created the brand account to transfer your YouTube account to, click on Advanced Settings and then click Move Channel to a Brand Account. This is a pretty sensitive operation, so you'll probably be asked to log in again. Once you log in, you can choose where to move this account. Next to the account you just created, there should be a Replace button. Click that button. Here you're confirming that you want to remove everything associated with the brand account. That should be fine because you created it 2 minutes ago. Click on Delete Channel. When you move the channel here, you'll obviously retain your subscribers, videos, playlists, channel name, icon, and URL. But you'll lose some things like your demographic history and your permissions. Specifically, if you've given someone else permissions to your channel, you might need to edit that after the fact. Once you're ready to go, click Move Channel. Okay, congratulations, you've just done step one. Continue by clicking on the channel icon in the top right once again, and make sure that you're on the brand account this time. Now it can get confusing here, so don't trip up. You just moved your old channel and handle to be a brand account. So the brand is actually this account. Now you've made double sure that you're in the correct account. Go back to your channel icon and then click on YouTube Studio. You'll probably get the welcome screen again. Click Continue to exit it and then click on Settings and click on Permissions again. If your permissions pane looks like this, where you have two different buttons, skip to the next chapter. If you're here with me now, that means your permissions pane looks like this, specifically including this statement. You need to manage permissions inside of your brand account. So click on the link that says Opt Out of Permissions. Read the fine print here because everyone who has access to your channel right now will lose their permissions. Acknowledge that you'll need to re-add them and then click on Opt Out. Now, if you're here with me, your permissions pane should look like this. Click on the Manage Permissions button at the top, then click on Manage Permissions. Click the Add User icon in the top right. Finally, you get to enter the new email address, which will control the channel. Type it in and then under Choose a Role, select Owner. Then click Invite. That email address then gets an invitation to become an owner of that account. Once you click Accept, you are a co-owner. But if you want to become the sole primary owner of the channel, you must click Manage Permissions again. Then where it says Owner, click on Primary Owner. Now make doubly sure that you assign this to the correct account because this person can remove all other owners. Once you're ready, click Transfer. And unfortunately, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but to be the primary owner, you must be an owner for more than 7 days. So you'll need to wait a week and then make yourself the primary owner once again. Now, before you go, I've got a question for you. Why did the YouTube channel refuse to move? Well, it didn't want to lose its subs. Stints. See you in the next video.